Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And today I'm going to start with a new series. It's related with the big data. I'm just going to start with big data series. In this particular series, I'm just going to cover what exactly the big data is. This is the first video and this will be the introductory video. In this introductory video, I'm just going to cover what exactly the big data is. What is big data analytics? What is the Hadoop? What are the big data ecosystem? And after that, subsequently, I will cover each and every topics related with the Hadoop. It's related with the Scoop. It's related with the Pig. It's related with the Flum. So my purpose is basically, I'm just going to give you each and everything related with the big data, related with the Hadoop and all. What you need to do, you just need to follow the video. That's it. So today I'm just going to start with the first thing related with the big data. The important thing that we need to understand what exactly the big data is, how it is different from the data. See, if I need to define the big data, my answer will be the data that will be bigger in the size is known as the big data. That's why it is called big data. The data that will be bigger in the size is known as the big data. Now we need to understand what is the real requirement of this big data. What is the real requirement of this big data analytics? See, like in the earlier edition of the computer, I'm talking about the 70s and all, to store the data, normally the file system was there. After the file system means there will be the file and all. In that particular file will contain the data. That's it. After that, the next concept was there. It's related with the databases, like I'm talking about the RDBMS concepts. Like the table will be there. In the table, the data will get stored. Like you can store the employee data, you can store the student data, you can store the customer data. But this is what? This is the era of the internet. This is the time of the internet we are talking about. Right now, we are having the Facebook, we are having the Instagram, we are having the Twitter, we are having the search engine, Google. Can you think about like how many posts per minute posted on the Facebook? Can you think about how many tweet messages per minute posted on the Twitter? Can you think about how many photos posted in Instagram per minute? I'm just giving you the detail. According to the Forbes, every minute, 4.15 million YouTube video watched. Every minute, 4.15 million YouTube video watched by the user. This is the data by the Forbes. Every minute I am talking about, 456,000 tweets posted on Twitter. Can you think about 456,000 tweets posted on the Twitter? For your kind information, for the Instagram user, this is the good news. Like 46,740 photos get uploaded on the Instagram. Can you think about? Now 510,000 comments posted on the Facebook every minute. Can you think about? Like 2,293,000 status get updated every minute on the Facebook. That's why I'm telling you, this is the era of the internet. This is the time of the internet. Now the data, it's a totally different kind of data we are having. So the thing is that, how to manage this data? Like the earlier concept was, okay, we need to store the employee data. Yeah, it's fine. We will store the employee data like employee number, employee name, employee salary and all. We are having the customer data, we will manage the customer data. Yeah, it's fine. In early 90s, it was fine. But 90s onwards, this is the era of the internet. The nature of the data get changed. The frequency of the data get changed. We are having the Google, we are having the search engine. Can you think about like every minute I am talking about how many users uses the Google in this world? That we need to think about. We need to think about what frequency of data is there. Can you think about the data generated by the satellite? Can you think about the data generated by the sensors? Can you think about the data generated by the share market? So these are the different areas, the data we need to manage. And for just to manage these kind of data, now we are having the concept of big data. We are having the concept of big data. The data that will be bigger in the size is known as the big data. The first thing, what exactly the big data is? If I'm talking about the big data means what? The data having big in size. Big means I'm talking about the frequency like this. That is known as the big data. See, the entire characteristics of the big data, we can define with the 5 V's. And these 5 V's are, these are the important characteristics of the big data. The first thing is the volume. When we are talking about the big data, we are talking about the volumes. Volumes means the size, huge size of the data. Variety. When we are talking about the big data, we are talking about the varieties of data. The data in the different format. It can be audio video data. It can be the text file. It can be the XML file. It can be the web data. It can be the tabular data. So I am talking about the different varieties, different sources of data in different formats. Velocity. Yeah, I am talking about the speed. I am talking about the speed. So, the first point was volume. The second is variety. The third one is the velocity. We are getting the data on the high speed. It's a velocity. And the next point is veracity. Veracity means what? Veracity means inconsistency and uncertainty of data. Inconsistency and uncertainty of data we are talking about. Inconsistency and uncertainty means what? We are not familiar like what will be the nature of the data. Suppose we are having the Facebook post. I am just going to give the post on the Facebook and you are going to post the comment over there. The comment might be in the single word, might be in the single character, might be some symbol will be there, might be some images will be there, might be some audio will be there, might be some video will be there. That is what, that is veracity I am talking about. And again, finally, the values. Why we are doing all these exercises? Just to generate the values from the data. Why we are doing all these exercises? Like we are talking about the big data, we are talking about the different tools, we are talking about the different hardwares. Why we are talking about this? Just to generate the values from the data. So, the complete characteristics of the big data is defined by these 5 V's. So, if you need to remember about the big data, what exactly the big data, you need to remember these 5 V's. Volume, variety, velocity, veracity and values. That we need to remember. Now, one important thing that also we need to remember, like what are the format of the big data? Format of big data. Now we can guess what will be the format of the big data. Like the format of the big data is, number one, it's a structured data we are talking about. A structured data means what? The data will be in the DBMS format, like in tabular format. I'm talking about the RDBMS. The data will be there in the tabular format. That is a structured data. In big data, the one category of the data will be the structured data. The second will be the semi-structured data. Semi-structured data means what? I am talking about the XML file. The data will be there in the XML file. I am talking about the JSON file. The data will be there in the JSON format. And the third thing, I am talking about the unstructured data. Unstructured data. We are talking about the unstructured data means I am talking about the video. I am talking about the audio. So these are the different format of the big data. So the first thing was, what is big data? What is the characteristics of the big data? And the third thing is, what is the format of the big data? Now, the next thing that we need to understand, like always when we are talking about the big data, people are talking about the big data analytics. So the first thing that we need to understand, what exactly the big data analytics is. See, here we are talking about the big data. Okay, suppose we are having the data, I am going to store the data. Now, after the storage of the data, what exactly we need to do? Why we are going to store the data? What is the use of the storage of the data? Like, I am going to use the hardware, I am going to use the software for that. Naturally, we need to store the data. The important thing is, why we need to store the data? Naturally, we need to generate the value from the data. And how we can generate the value? For that purpose, the big data analytics is. Big data analytics means what? We need to find out the customer behavior. We need to find out, we need to analyze the sales of the company. We need to analyze, suppose I am running particular business. I need to find out what are the area that we need to focus on. We need to focus for the sales. Suppose we are having the company for the particular laptop. That brand belongs to me. And suppose my laptop, its worldwide sale is there. And I'm just getting that in India, in the USA market, my product is going, it's doing well. Like sale is very high. But again, I need to take the decision after the India, after the USA, what country will be beneficial for me to generate the business? How I can generate the business? How I can maximize my profit? This is the time for the data you need to remember. Remember, the country, the companies, those having the proper management of the data, naturally having the better future. If I need to take the decision, to take the decisions on the base of particular data, on the particular, for that purpose, what we need to do? We need to do the big data analytics. So big data is a different term. Big data means we are talking about how to store the data. Big data means we are talking about how to store the data. And big data analytics means we are talking about how to process the stored data to get the result in proper way. Proper way means what? How we can maximize the profit for the companies. That's ultimately the goal of the big data analytics. Now, so basically it's a two confusing term is there. Normally people think like big data analytics, big data. Big data is the different thing. Big data analytics is the different things. Now, these are the different tools. These tools we can use to manage the big data. And the most popular tool is like Hadoop. Hadoop is basically, it's an open source. It's an open source written in Java. And the basic purpose of the Hadoop is, it's a product of Apache. The basic purpose, see, in the big data, what are the big challenges over there? The big challenge is how to store the data. The big challenge is how to process the data. How to process the data. So basically, Hadoop is what? It's an open source framework. And by the use of this open source framework is written in Java, what we can do? We can store the data. For that purpose, we are having the concept of HDFS. Hadoop file system is there in the Hadoop. And again, it's not only the storage we are talking about, we are also talking about how to process the data. Like we are having the data, how to process the data? For that purpose, we are having the MapReduce. So Hadoop is basically the open source framework. That open source framework is written in Java, and by the use of Hadoop,
What we can do, we can store the big data. For that purpose, in Hadoop, we are having the HDFS. We can process the data. For that purpose, we are having the MapReduce. Other than this Hadoop and all, we are having the different tools over there, and different softwares are there. That software make the big data Hadoop ecosystem. Like we are having the Pig. We are having the Scoop. We are having the Hive. We are having the HBase. We are having the Flum. We are having the Cassandra. So basically, these are what? These are the different softwares. By the use of these softwares, what we can do? Like Pig is there, like Hive is there, like HBase is there, like Cassandra is there. By the use of Cassandra, by the use of HBase, by the use of Hive, by the use of Pig, what we can do? We can store the data. We can store the data more or less. We can store the data in proper format, whether it's a structured, it's unstructured. Like we are having the Scoop, it's a different purpose is there. How we can transfer the data from the HDFS to this file system, or from these different softwares to HDFS. So I am not going to talk about like in detail about this. Basically, all these makes the Hadoop ecosystem. So if I need to learn, so what will be the learning path? If I need to learn the Hadoop, if I need to learn the big data, this will be the learning path for the Hadoop. If someone is planning for going for the Hadoop, because it's in big demand, and the future belongs to the big data, the future belongs to the Hadoop. In big data, the Hadoop is the most popular one, and the future, like suppose you need is as a fresher, if you are looking for the jobs and all, this is a good choice you can go for. And what will be the learning path for the Hadoop? For the Hadoop, the first thing that you need to start with initially is just to start with the Linux command. After the Linux command, you can go with the Hadoop and all. Hadoop and all. In the Hadoop, naturally, we need to learn the HDFS. We need to learn about the MapReduce. Other than the HDFS MapReduce, we need to learn about the Pig. We need to learn about the Scoop, Hive, HBase, Plum, Cassandra. A lot of things are there that we need to learn. But it will get start from the Linux. In my next video, I will just go for the Linux. I will go with the Hadoop installation, how to install the Hadoop and all. And for your any suggestion, for your any feedback, you can give your feedback, your suggestions in the comment and all. And it's really nice, like you are just using this video in the proper way. And if you are not using in that particular way, it's my personal suggestion that try to understand what exactly the concept of big data. This is my first video. This is just the introductory video. In the next video, I will start with the Hadoop installation. For the Hadoop, we can install the Hadoop in the Windows or it's in Linux. But Windows is not popular. We will start with the Linux installation. So in the next video, it's all about the Linux installation. It's all about the Ubuntu installation. For the time being, just enjoy this video. Give your suggestions, your feedback. Thanks a lot.